Pastor Amy. We're going to continue on with our theme of Subscribe Now. Today's lesson is about how Jesus knows you. Before we get started, let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for being an awesome friend. We pray for this message to enter our hearts and to teach us a new lesson. God, we just welcome you in our everyday lives, and we thank you for knowing us. Amen. Our verse for the theme is John 14:6, where Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." These days, you can find anything and anyone online. You could look up your favorite sports team, your favorite celebrity, you can do anything. But even if you know a lot of facts about someone, it doesn't mean that you actually know them, and it definitely doesn't mean that they know you. We're gonna do something new, and we're gonna do a little activity. I'm gonna ask some questions, and if the answer is yes, give a thumbs up, and if the answer is no, give a thumbs down. The first question is, does your best friend know your middle name? Does your neighbor know your cat's name? And does your grandma know your favorite color? The point is that even the people who really know you don't know every single thing about you. The only person in the whole world who knows everything about you is Jesus. We're gonna bring in another guest star today, and it's Miss Rena, who used to do these videos for you, and she's super excited to share the story of Philip and Nathanael meeting Jesus.
Hi friends, it's Miss Rena. I'm so excited to be here with you again today and to be here with my friend, Pastor Amy. So today, I'm talking about Philip and Nathan. And we find about Nathanael. We find out about them in John chapter 1, verses 43 through 50. I'm going to just call them Nate and Phil because those are names we hear more often. So as Phil was hanging out and learning all about Jesus, people would talk about Jesus, and he was getting so excited. And one day, Jesus saw Phil, and he said, "Phil, why don't you follow me? Come and hang out with me and see what I'm really like." Phil got so excited. He really wanted to get to know Jesus, but he needed his best friend to know Jesus too. So he ran and he found Nate, and Nate was sitting right under a big tree. And he said, Nate, I met the most awesome guy. He's from Nazareth. And Nate got mad. He didn't want to share his friend. And he said, "Can anything good come from Nazareth?" And instead of Philip saying, "Oh," and getting angry and saying, "I think it can," he trusted Jesus. He said, "You should just come meet him yourself. Come see for yourself if he's as good as I say he is." And so Nate followed Phil and met Jesus. And as soon as Jesus saw Nate, he said, "Hey Nate, I saw you earlier under the tree." And Nate's eyes got really big and he said, "You saw me, you know me." And Jesus said, "Just watch, I'll do even better things."
That was so fun, thank you, Miss Serena. Online, people request to follow or be friends with other people. But how do you know when to accept or to not accept those people? Oftentimes, you end up being friends on social media with people who aren't friends in real life. What does it mean to be a real friend in real life? I can tell you that Jesus is the best friend ever, and he's so excited to be friends with you, and he knows all the awesome things about you. Psalm 139 is all about how Jesus sees you and has planned every day of your life, and he knows every little detail because you are his perfect creation and he delights in who you are. Philip invited Nathanael to be friends with Jesus. What friend can you invite to also be friends with Jesus? This week, ask your parents if you can use a dry erase marker and write, "Jesus knows me," on your bathroom mirror. Don't worry, it comes off. But that way, every time you look in the mirror, and when you see your eyes and your cheekbones and your hair, you know that Jesus sees you too, and he knows and loves every little detail. Let's pray. Lord God, thank you for creating us exactly like you did. Thank you for knowing our names and knowing our hearts. Thank you for knowing our insecurities and the things that we're confident in. God, we know that we were created perfect. So I pray for that confidence in the details. God, we know that you are good and that you delight in us. So I pray for that same delight to wash over us, God, that we will see ourselves the way that you see us and that we invite other people into this friendship with you. Amen. All right, guys, I will see you for the craft. The supplies you're going to need for today's craft is yarn or string, a pen or marker, a hole puncher, a glue stick, scissors, some pictures of yourself, and if you're not able to print out some pictures of yourself, you can just draw pictures, and then however many pictures you have, you're going to want that many note cards. So I have 5 pictures and 5 note cards. We're going to make a little photo book of ourselves to show how Jesus has always known us. Once you've either drawn all your pictures or cut them out, you're going to stack up your note cards and do 2 hole punches at the top. Then you're going to cut off 2 pieces of yarn. So I have my 2 pieces of string, then you're going to thread it through the hole punch. You're going to tie a knot, but you're not going to do it too tight. So you double knot it, but you have space right here. So now I have my little flip book. Next, I'm going to glue my pictures on. On the cover, I'm going to put a picture of myself that's pretty recent. Because, of course, I know that Jesus knows me now. But just like he knows me now, he knew me before I was even born. It says that in Psalm 139, that Jesus knew you before you were even born. So this is an ultrasound picture. Then a picture of me as a baby, me as a toddler, and lastly, a picture of me as a teenager. Then, once you've put all your pictures on, you're going to write, "Jesus knows me," on the cover. And then you're done. So you have your little photo book of pictures of you throughout your life to show that Jesus has always known you. I hope you love the craft. Hey guys, thanks for watching. I hope you love the video. Be sure to have your mom or dad like, subscribe, share the video with your friends, post pictures of your crafts in the comments. We'd love to see what you created. Have a great week. Bye.